So far, Malkuth put Philip out of his misery. And Eileen and her cultists, they were shut down for good. As for what Hood had to deal with, we'll be going over that. Hood was up against Greta, the ape chef, the cannibal. It's why Hood was wielding the power of Eileen. That was gonna be needed. As for the fresh meats, roughly translated, Greta killed and ate the of a seven chefs. All that was certain with our predatory opponents, or rather, Poe's predatory opponent, is that the fresh meat isn't meant to be the primary target. The primary target was meant to be Greta. All to cause as much damage as possible. Thankfully, Hood has smoke immunity. Which was why she was equipped with pretty much a lot of smoke dealing abilities. And Greta, she ain't making it easy. In that case, time to act like a bunch of fishermen. And go shark hunt. And no, not to eat. We're not the kind that do that does that. No wonder the purple terror would be concerned about taking her on along with the others. It'd be a fight that there'd be no chance of winning. Yeah, all of the literature team had to choose their moves wisely. Well, asking themselves, what can they afford to use and what can't they afford to use? Yeah, they're taking the beat. And not just through counterattacks. Yeah. All wrapped in the cocoon. That's what one of them was. And Greta. Well, at least noticed that she was focusing on the fresh meat. In a I want to eat this kind of way. So the others recognize the necessity of making sure that doesn't happen. And it could also help to make some improvements all around for what's to come. Taking into consideration that sharks go on a frenzy when they smell blood. And I doubt that Greta would be much different. Oh yeah. A combined assault. Not really going that well. But Greta's resilience, her inability to withstand, or rather her ability to withstand a lot, even that was finite. She could smell her own blood. And she can also burn. Okay. Is it just me, Or has Greta been one that suffered from some kind of prion infection? Well, it would certainly explain why she has completely lost her mind. Well, I can tell you what it is then. Passion. Yeah, I'm sure the Purple Terror's ability to switch stances has its uses. But in this case, the use is, well, slashing Greta up. And Greta, by this point, is growing impatient. There's likely a lot to go around as far as beatdowns are concerned. It was just a matter of choosing what goes where. And Nyx didn't have a lot to work with. Yeah, it felt like everyone was going nowhere. As so far, they've barely made a dent in Greta. Yeah, and somehow, indiscriminate burning, not a good idea. Largely because well, something needs to make a lesser target out of the literature team. Yeah, takes a lot to break through her defenses. Now even feasting on raw meat would make a difference. Yeah, somehow that power wasn't so useful. Thankfully, the EGO of the spider bud would be. And she had recovered from her injury. From her beatdown. After eating that fresh meat. Which meant they needed to be broken down all over again. Yeah, I know, it's irritating. But what can you do? Yeah, I know, it's unlikely to break through, but it's at least worth trying. Speaking of breaking through, it was a lot more defensive. Which suited the literature team fine, as it wasn't a good idea to provoke Greta. At least not unless serious damage could be dealt. Yeah, and by this point, the literature team could move. Which was surprisingly effective. But not enough to break her guard. Yeah, this called for red eye. Time to grind them into the ever-spinning gear wheel. And believe me, it's gonna hurt. Well, hopefully it'll hurt. I fought the time. It was getting... to a point where I didn't know what needed to be done. And hope that who did. Well, with as much as could be done, well, at least with red eyes, Greta would be severely weakened. After this, well, it couldn't hurt to be full of alertness. Along with a sanguine desire. Ooh, quite fitting, considering what Greta's been getting. And what a time to bleep. And I promise you this, bleeding was the last thing on the minds of the opponent of the literature team. This was largely because, usually, she's delivering it. Yeah, Arya couldn't use the sanguine desire, but Nyx could. Yeah, surprising. That it was actually used. Yeah, that was some last minute rethinking. but, well, we'd see what it does. Or rather, what it did. Sanguine desire. It hit hard. Unfortunately, it also led to Greta giving up on what subtlety she had left. And singled out Nyx. Well, since there was no reason to be stingy with the light that Nyx had, because she didn't have enough. Yeah, I couldn't use an EGU because they're both recovering power. There's the hope that it will recover by the time Greta was done with whatever she had planned for Nyx, and based on what she was, well, based on the way she was looking at, the wheel of the purple terrorist power, it wasn't looking good. I can see why the blue sicko recruited her. Well, thankfully, she was less able to take the beat from the rest of the literature team. And Nyx, well, feels a target. Well, she was a useful distraction. One that the literature team would make the most of, while also trying to get around. Time was short with the psycho chef. It was hard to tell what would come first. But Aura, well, her demise went first, unfortunately. Yeah, it was relatively easy to prioritize talk. The problem with that was whether or not it would make a difference. Well, in this case, it did. Those red shoes actually proved useful in this battle. Netzach was up against the musicians of Bremen. A twisted amalgamation of three of those still around, along with Miss Mermaid of the 8 o'clock circus, a couple of puppets, and probably the last remaining Church of Giz worshiper, who probably isn't too happy with the library taking their leader and turning her into a book. Well, not my problem. And I doubt that Netzach cares about that either. Although, to be honest, he doesn't really care about much of anything. Well, the puppets, they're not much different. Neither are the capabilities of the Church of Gears worshiper. Similar to how Gesod had to them up, and not with his atheism. Yeah, that's right. It's Netzach's arts team versus the musicians of Bremen. Let's have a break before we go over that battle. It was certainly an interesting one. I'll say that much.